So the first thing I do in SurvCE is I go to equipment, GPS rover. On my current tab, I go to GeoMax Zenith35 tag. And I go to comms. I have the serial number of the receiver. I go to RTK. I'm on our eGPS network. I'm on eGPS VRS. These receivers are GLONASS to do GLONASS RTCM. Actually, I'm on Geo++, so I'm using PRS-R3, which is the RTCM 3.0 message type. I get connected. Once I get connected and get fixed, I'll start the calibration. I use this little adapter right here because it's much easier once I get rolling on this calibrate. Okay. First thing I do is I go to survey and store points and I see if I'm fixed, which I'm fixed. So I come out of there. I go back to equipment and GPS utilities. Okay. I have 8 options on the screen. Configure RTK, network connect, network disconnect, power off receiver, reset RTK engine, sensor calibration is the one we're going to use, GPS raw utilities, and send command. Okay, I'm going to do a sensor calibrate. When I open it, now I have 4 options. Full sensor calibration, tilt calibration, auto, tilt calibration set horizontal, and 1-point sensor test. We're going to do a full sensor calibration. Everything is based on your rod bubble, so you need to make sure that your rod bubble is good. So I hit full sensor calibration. First, we just go through these one at a time. The first one is tilt calibration set horizontal. So I'm going to hit tilt calibration. Comes up, I make sure my rod is plumb according to this bubble. I hit set 0 and it'll go through. It says GNSS level calibration successful. I say okay. I hit the back arrow. Now I'm going to go to the magnetic spin. This is a 2-part process. The first one that I'm doing, since this is set horizontal, is the horizontal spin. Okay, I'm gonna say set horizontal. With this new version, it goes into preparing. Once it's ready, there's a diagram right here that tells you which way to spin this receiver, and there's another screenshot over here that's going to be filled up with points, and I'm going to make a circle. So now I'm just going to start spinning the receiver very slowly so I get the circle filled up on the first time. There is a progress bar about midway down the screen that tells you when you get there. But you'll see the points show up and they'll make a semi-perfect circle. And the slower you go, the better it is. Circle to be completely white when I'm done. So okay, that's the horizontal. This is where the adapter comes in really handy. I can pull this receiver off because our next spin will be vertical, so we put our handy dandy vertical adapter on. set my receiver up. Make sure I'm plugged. And I'm gonna choose to set start vertical calibration. And I'm gonna start spinning my receiver vertically. Again, I have the progress bar. When it's complete, there'll be a green check marking the vertical and horizontal. If you don't have this adapter, you're spinning the rod the whole time. Calibration needs to be done every 100 miles that you travel if you're going to use the IMU. Getting close. Okay, so now we've done both the horizontal and the vertical. There's another button on the bottom that says update calibration, so we say update. Calibration successful, so you just tell it okay. We'll take this off. And I just stick it in my pocket. Once again, I make sure I'm plumb. Now I'm going to do a directional incline, which is step number 3. The first command it asks you for is to start center. So you want to be plumb, you want to be fixed on the network. I'm giving it just a minute to make sure it's fixed. And once it's fixed, we'll start taking the shot. It'll tell you if you're fixed or float right here. So we're waiting on it to get fixed. That's all we're waiting on. I'm going to start center, and it's going to ding a few times. Okay, so we've got our center calibrated with where our bubble is on our rod. All this is bubble dependent. I'm going to start the incline. I'm trying to stay on my point. It's going to ask me to go east, south, west, and north in that order at a 25 to 35 degree angle, okay, leaning. So I'm going to get close to where I need to be. That was east. Now I'm going south. And it also tells you your azimuth here, so you know which way you're looking and the angle of your incline. Then I'll go north. say update calibration. Calibration successful. Okay, so we have calibrated our GPS. So what we do now, what I do, I go back into sensor calibration after I come out. I do a 1-point sensor test. First thing, I make sure I'm good and plumb. And these bob-bobs can be real handy for this, so you're not shaking. And I'll hit start. And it takes 3 shots. Then, because this is the tilt and go feature, I will lean this over here at about 30 degrees. And I will look at my distance error. I know that my receiver is 2+ feet off of that point, and it's fluctuating anywhere from 1/10 to 4/100 off of that nail that's at the bottom of the pole. My elevations are between 1/10 and 7/100. So I'm good. I can take a shot leaning this pole now because my sensors are calibrated instead of being plumb. And that's all. We have now calibrated our GeoMax Zenith35 Pro Tag.